Hey Longhorns, today is Tuesday, February 9th, 2016. I'm Peyton.
And I'm Morgan. Welcome to the 70th edition of the Longhorn Daily News.
Remind our staff that the GRHS choir will be delivering singing Valentines to your classrooms today.
Peyton, I know who you're getting one from.
Who?
Me. Okay. It's time for another Pennies for Patients presale. Get your t-shirt this time and don't miss out. They are only $15. Order forms are at the student service window due by this Friday.
Another one. Another Pennies for Patients t-shirt sale. Get your t-shirt. It's only $15. The money that we raise will go towards patients with leukemia. This is the front, and this is the back. So get your t-shirt.
Good afternoon, advisory.
Good afternoon, Ms. Debbie.
So you know Student Council has been doing Pennies for Patients for a while now to help raise money for leukemia and lymphoma patients. Well, now they're doing this kind of fundraiser thing throughout the entire advisories where it's pasta for pennies, where the advisory who raises the most money gets a pasta party for the Olive Garden. So please, guys, donate so we can help patients and also get some pasta in it, too. Woo! And giving towards these patients that can help them have better lives and not only help them but also help us get some pasta. Thank you.
Woo!
Pasta, 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 pasta.
Come watch Mr. Croft, Miss Vela, Mr. Troop, and more of your favorite teachers and staff, Whip and Nene, at the 4th annual Dancing with the Staff. It's a hilarious good time you won't want to miss. The event is Thursday, February 11th at 7 p.m. at the GRHS Auditorium. Admission is $5 for all ages. Here's a sneak peek at some of the performances you'll be seeing.
You already know what it is. Silent talk, silent talk, silent talk. Go on and do it for me.
Now watch me whip. Now watch me, nae-nae.
Okay.
Now watch me whip, whip. Watch me, nae-nae.
Why me do?
George Ranch High School will soon be hosting their 4th annual Dancing with the Staff. Don't miss out on this chance to watch your own friends and teachers pair up in this fun dance battle.
Watch me, ooh, okay, ooh, okay, ooh. Watch me, watch me, ooh, watch me, watch me,
you do.
Watch me, watch me,
you do.
Okay, ooh,
do the stanky leg,
stank.
Do the stanky leg.
Stank, stank.
Break your legs,
break the knot.
Tell them break your legs,
break them.
Break your legs,
break the knot
and break your legs.
UNICEF Club will be selling chocolate-covered strawberries during all lunches on Friday, February the 12th. They will be sold for $2 for $2, and all of the proceeds will go towards UNICEF. Here's some of the information on this.
UNICEF Club will be selling chocolate-covered strawberries during all lunches on Friday, February the 12th. They will be sold for $2 for $1, and all of the proceeds will go directing toward UNICEF.
Now here's Lucas with the sports news.
On Friday, the Longhorn women's basketball teams took on Lamar. The JV came out with a win 33-17. The varsity won 55-41, clinching the district title. Alexis White and Julia Schwach both scored 17 points in the win. The next game will be tomorrow at home against Calhoun. The JV boys basketball team defeated the Lamar Mustangs on Friday night. The team was led by Isaac Sullivan and Jordan Johnson. The varsity boys basketball team put together a great team effort and defeated the Lamar Mustangs 65-42. The team was led by Chris Oliver's 6 three-pointers and a great play off the bench from Justin Joyner and Chikwama O. The George Ranch varsity boys soccer team lost a tough game against the Lamar Mustangs Friday night, 2-0. The Longhorns took forward to their next match where they take on Port Lavaca Calhoun next Tuesday night. GRHS Swimming and Diving competed in the Region 7 swim meet this weekend. The boys were regional runner-ups and girls took third place overall, We set 5 school records and will be taking 3 relays and 3 individual swims and 1 diver to the state championship meet in Austin, February 17th through 20th. Friday night, the girls' soccer team started the district season by hosting the Lady Mustangs from Lamar. The JV got things started with a 2-1 victory. The goals were scored by Emma Carlson and Grace Ramirez. All contributing with the strong effort were Carson Yanta and Noelle Hernandez and Heidi Jacko. The varsity continued the winning ways, defeating the Lady Mustangs 6-0. Celeste Ruiz led scoring with 2 goals with Taylor Retch, Jordan S., and Megan Berger. Sydney Hekela all adding 1 goal. Shreya Desai set a new school record for tallying 6 assists. The girl head to Calhoun on tomorrow to continue their quest for a 3rd district title. The GRHS varsity tennis team traveled to Wharton this past Friday. The team earned medals in 6 of 10 draws. If you're interested in trying out for 2016-2017 cheerleading squad, packets are now available at the student service window. There's a mandatory candidate and parent meeting scheduled for Monday, February 22nd, 2016 at 6:30 p.m. in the LGI. Now back to you.
In celebration of Black History Month, we spend a moment each day recognizing the enormous contributions of men and women in our nation's history who have spent their lives bettering our culture, our society, and our lives as a whole.
Mae Carroll Jemison became the first African-American woman to travel in space when she went into orbit aboard the Space Shuttle Endeavour on September 12, 1992. A doctor by trade, Jemison served in the Peace Corps from 1985 to 1987, when she was selected by NASA to join the Astronaut Corps. In addition to being a doctor and astronaut, she has also been an actor for Star Trek Next Generation and a primary dancer with the Alvin Alley Dance Company. Never one to reset, she is principal of the 100-year Starship organization and holds 9 honorary doctorates in science, engineering, letters, and the humanities.
Now here are the Longhorns who are celebrating their birthdays: Deja Johnson, Elmore Boranaga, Preston Allen,
Selma DeRue, Stacy Chukwujekwu. The broadcast team hopes you have an amazing birthday. And now we close off with a message from the PSAT team, who's going to explain how to analyze the PSAT scores you will be receiving today.
Congratulations on taking the PSAT and MSQT. Now it's time to see your scores, which you can get on your phone, computer, or on paper copies mailed to your school. The first thing you'll see is your total score, which is a combination of your scores on the evidence-based reading and writing and math sections. These scores give you an idea of how you'll do on the SAT and how ready you are for college. Next, your test scores, cross-test scores, and sub-scores give you even more details about how you did in specific areas. Scores in green show your strengths. Scores in yellow and red help you understand where you need to improve. Then go to Skills Insight to dig even deeper and see what your scores say about your skills and how you can develop them further. Thinking about your scores and making a plan to improve are important steps towards college. Test takers are screened for the National Merit Scholarship Program, an academic competition for recognition and scholarships. Go to the NMSC Selection Index section to see if you meet the entry requirements. Taking challenging classes is another great way to prepare for college. The AP Potential section tells you which AP classes would be great for you. Speak to your teacher or counselor to learn more about AP. Now that you know what your scores mean, use them to get free, personalized practice for the SAT. Go to satpractice.org to create and link your College Board and Khan Academy accounts to get started. Your test scores will feed into Khan Academy, which will give you a personalized practice program to help you study for the SAT. And finally, don't forget to register for the SAT.